Hello everybody, welcome to Thorough Newspaper Analysis brought to you by LawSeekho. Let's see what all articles are important for today. So the first article that we'll be talking about is called Potholes on the Digital Payment Superhighway. Here we will talk everything about digital payment, which has essentially become the hot topic and the technology that everybody is using these days, and we will see what improvements the government is proposing to make in the system. The second article for today is The Manacles of Caste in Sanitation World. Here we talk about sanitation system in India and how caste still plays a major role in how the sanitation work goes on. And lastly, the news and flash section, which is LawSeekho's own initiative, where we discuss crisp and short news analysis for your preliminary exams point of view. Before moving forward, let's look at LawSeekho's courses. We have the Lord of the Course Judiciary Test Prep course for you, where if you're a judicial service aspirant, we highly recommend this course. You can also click on this download button here and get free study material. We have other courses like for bar exam, for CLAT exam, and SEBI grade exam. Coming back to the news analysis, the MCQ for today is RTGS stands for Real Time Gross Settlement, Real Time General Scheme, Real-Time Gross Settlement System, and Real-Time Gross System. Please mention in the comment box what you think the correct answer is. The descriptive question for today is, despite the law banning manual scavenging, it is a harsh reality that the practice still exists in India. Critically examine. So you should write this answer approximately around in 250 words. Please do write, as the many questions you practice, your writing skills will improve accordingly. Now, coming back to our analysis, coming back to the first article, which was about digital payment system in India. So we all have in some way or the other used the digital payment system that have been prevailing in our economy these days, from shopping online retail, or on the other hand, it may be your stock transactions. Everywhere the payment you make is online, which goes through a digital payment system, which is why this is such a hot topic and everybody should know about it. So with the increasing versatility and ease of settling financial transactions, the growth of digital payments is expected to be phenomenal. This whole digital payment system is supported by banks and fintech companies, and clearly the growth is phenomenal, since we all are aware about how raging the system is. Now, the article talks about the evolution of digital payment system in India. So in 1998, RBI published a paper called Payment Systems in India. This paper essentially covers the historical background of how payment systems evolved in India. However, let's see how digital payment system evolved in India. In 2004, RBI launched the real-time gross settlement system, which we all know as RTGS now. A huge amount of money can be quickly transferred across from one person or one institution to another, which has been a big breakthrough in the payment system in India. RTGS covered large value payments on stock and bond trading. Then again, in 2005, RBI introduced National Electronic Fund Transfers. This also we all are aware about. This is called NEFT in popular terms. Then in 2009, RBI set up the National Payment Corporation of India. Now in 2004 and 2005, RTGS and NEFT had come into place and a lot of people were using that. However, a need was felt by the government to introduce an umbrella academy to govern both these systems. So National Payment Corporation of India was evolved. This was an umbrella retail payment institution, which looked, which under it came all these payments, small payment systems, which were hugely popular. The system of National Payment Corporation of India was inspired by BCGAB model in Sweden. So this is a bank in Sweden, which inspired the system of National Payment Corporation of India. Now, let's see why everybody is saying that digital payment is such a huge success in India. So the whole payment of digital system is supported by RBI as well as the government. Now, digital payment is a public good because public largely uses it. It has become an alternative to currency in India. And therefore, it becomes the duty of RBI as a state bank as well as the government to support the system as an extended arm of the sovereign. It was seen that the government or the RBI was not looking at digital payments as a profit-making machinery. Rather, the profit potential was contained, and which is one of the reasons why NPCI, the National Payment Corporation of India, became such a huge success. Because the focus here was not just making of profit, rather the focus here was a public good. So NPCI's success against international payers is recognized by central banks in many countries. Because the motive here was not a profit making, NPCI has become a huge success, and its success is also recognized by international payers. It is the endorsement by Bank for International Settlement. It is endorsed worldwide. Now let's see what steps are required to further make digital payment system in India a further huge success. So what may be required is financial support from RBI and government. Although RBI and government are already supporting the digital payment system in India, they are coming up the budget 2020-21. The government prescribes zero merchant discount rate. So there is a discount rate that is given. There's a fee that is paid by merchants to these institutions. However, the government prescribes zero merchant discount rate. So by this, what will happen is that because the discount rate will be reduced, the payment, the digital payment system itself will become popular. Now, by reducing the price, the aim is to popularize the digital payment system. Secondly, what the government can do is it can settle the price. So there's a disparity between how price should be settled between digital payment systems. So the article suggests that this analysis of pricing should be based on producer surplus, consumer surplus, as well as social welfare. So just how a normal market functions, where the price is settled by seeing the surplus and the welfare functions. Similarly, here also the price should be settled by seeing producer surplus, consumer surplus, as well as social welfare. Moving to another article for today, which is about caste and sanitation work. So, you all have heard about this the system in India, which is also called manual scavenging, where people go inside manholes and clean basically the excreta and the excreta which is there in the manholes. And this is done by people who actually go inside the manholes. Now what happens is a lot of people have died in the recent past, because when you go inside the manholes, it is filled with very toxic gases, which are very deadly and which can cause very deadly harm to a human being. So even in 2020, the Indian government and civil society continue to fight inhuman nature of manual scavenging. Manhole deaths and safety equipments to sanitation workers. This is not adequately provided to sanitation workers, which is why we are seeing huge number of deaths because of people going inside the manhole for sanitation work. So let's see what is the history of manual scavenging in India. Historically, manual scavenging has been a task designated for particular communities. Historically, people would go to different houses and pick up the excreta of people manually and then throw it to designated places. Prior to 1993, state governments had a post called scavengers. The purpose of these scavengers was to manually remove human excreta in households and designated places. A scavenging tax was levied on people who would want the human excreta to be removed from their houses. So this is what was happening before 1993. Now, in 1993, a law was passed. This law was called Employment of Manual Scavengers and Construction of Dry Latrines Prohibition Act. So under this law, what happened was that the state government was given the duty to prohibit employment of manual scavengers and construction of dry latrines. So dry latrine was defined as latrines other than a water sealed latrine. Now this is a very loose definition if you look at it. So because the definition is so loose, the purpose of the act, which was to avoid manual scavenging, essentially the purpose was defeated because the definitions were so loose. So what happened was that the governments which were earlier employing scavengers, they themselves became the agencies to prohibit the employment now, because now the governments had to say no, we cannot employ the manual scavengers. However, the purpose was not fully achieved because the law was not properly drafted. It was very loosely drafted. Because of this, in 2013, a survey was conducted on manual scavenging, which said that dry latrines and manual scavengers still existed even after the passing of the law. And death in manholes and sewers was still high. Now, the present government plans to amend the 2013 Act. So, how do they plan to improve the condition of manual scavenging is by mechanizing the process of cleaning sewers and manholes. So they will employ machinery to do what human beings do in such a deadly and toxic gas environment. And they will build new sewers so that machines could be fitted in it and the task could be performed by machinery. So let's see how the government goes forward with it. This is a very very properly planned approach, because definitely we need machinery to do this work. However, the implementation of this scheme is what needs to be looked forward to. And here is a reality check again. Nor the past or the present amendments addresses the issue of labor safety. Again, here the government is planning to employ machinery, but the issue of labor safety is not addressed by the law itself. So manual scavengers are still hired by local authorities, and the local authorities hire manual scavengers on the basis of caste, which is an even bigger issue, that manual scavenging happens, which is a labor safety issue. Further, the manual scavenging happens on the basis of caste, which is a huge problem for the Indian society. Secondly, no union exists for manual scavengers. So in states like Tamil Nadu, all political parties have trade unions for government servants except for sanitation workers. Why this is so? Because mainly sanitation workers are considered unholy, and this job is considered to be a low job in India. Hardly any organized movement demanded a permanent job status for sanitation workers. So they have a temporary job status. They have inhumane work hours and inhumane work conditions. And also the job is given on the basis of caste. So nothing can be more inhumane than this whole system of manual scavenging in India. And this needs a proper check and balances. And proper improvement plan needs to be issued in case of the sanitation workers in India. Coming to the news and flash section, first, state of global air 2020. Released by US-based Health Effect Institute, as per this report, long-term exposure to air pollution contributed to over 1.67 million annual deaths in India in 2019. Now, we know that in around this time, a huge issue is faced in Delhi and neighboring states about air pollution. And this report further strengthens the claim that we have a huge issue of air pollution and the government needs to deal with this. So air pollution is now the largest risk factor for death among all health risks. Secondly, INS Kavarati. So indigenous stealth will be commissioned into Indian Navy in Visakhapatnam today. This is the last of the four indigenously built anti-submarine warfare stealth corvettes designed by Indian Navy's in-house organizations, Directorate of Naval Design, and built by Garden Reach Shipbuilder and Engineers for Calcutta. So it's important that you remember these names, because sometimes in preliminary exams, these type of names are asked about what is the ship that has been commissioned in the Indian Navy, etc. So it will be good if you remembered all these names. So this was all for today. Thank you. Hope you learn in this session, and keep tuned to Lossy Post for more such sessions. Thank you.